deals to be good.
Just like before, you've already done. You've done lines, true? You've done shape.
Yeah.
You've done value, you've done form, and a space. You're almost there, so the second quarter, we're talking space, color, and texture. That should get us to the end of December. Color, that's painting.
Yay!
Texture, that's painting. Space, this is more 3D. We'll talk about that on Tuesday. Paint, with me. Here's your definition. Yes, write down your definition. On the other paper. Make your list as always. Make your list of values, elements, sorry. Make your list of elements, and then write down your definition. Separate paper, I've already said that 4 times. Keep up.
On paper.
Oh, sorry.
Because you never gave it to him.
Okay, so space. Space refers to the distance or areas around, between, and within components of this piece. Space can be positive or negative, open or closed, shallow or deep, and two-dimensional or three-dimensional. You as the artist, we're talking in two-dimensional, and sometimes we'll talk about three-dimensional. It's more ceramics, it's more sculpture, that's more of that kind of thing. But a few things I want you to understand today. Today I'll talk a little bit about positive and negative space. Open and closed, not so much. The other stuff, I'll bring it up as we go along through this class and last year. Give me a thumbs up when you're ready, but obviously, you're not ready. You as people in the classroom, you're taking up space. So that's kind of part of art. You understand where you are relatively in the room as compared to other people. Got it?
No.
Got it?
No.
Got it?
No.
So we're just saying no, just to say no. One person at your desk has it, the rest of you get that. I gotta move on. Ready?
No.
Okay, I'll come back to it.
I got it.
So, these, I need you to write down these. These are the 6 ways artists can create different. The illusion of space. So we're talking the illusion of space on a two-dimensional plane. We need to talk about overlapping, placement on the paper, size, detailed color value, about the same, and perspective. So you make that list, but as I go through, they'll be on the top of each of the fields. So let me get started. At least write down overlap if you have the first one. Positive and negative space. Overlapping was the first one. Positive and negative space. Everything on a piece of paper is either positive or negative. When you have an image or a drawing or something that's on the physical paper, that's the positive part. Anything around it that's blank or white or obviously or black paper like yesterday, that's the negative part. If you can understand this, you're going to more than likely understand how to place objects on your paper and know the difference between both fields. That's just the simple version. Here is the way to talk about it. So, overlapping. In the beginning of time, when you started drawing as kindergarten, preschool, first grade, you started drawing stuff where you had a stick figure, then you had like something that looked like a car, and then a cat that looked similar but same size as the car. And then you had maybe the sun, but you had everything standing next to each other. Until one day you started realizing that things can overlap. And that's probably the beginning of when you started realizing there's depth to the drawing, or depth, there's, you know, further back on a paper or canvas or anything. Overlapping is the beginning of that. Obviously the red one is in front of the blue one. You can wrap your head around the illusion that something is closer to you than it is like the blue one, yet they're the exact same size, right? Overlapping is your first one. Number two, placement. Placement on the paper. Along with this concept, you've already put this two together in your head. One looks closer to you than the other. Red looks to be up front, but they're exactly the same size. But why does one look further ahead than the other? Because of placement. You establish a horizon line, and then anything that's closer to the bottom of the page will probably seem or look closer to you than anything further back. That's placement. Objects placed higher are further. That's the second way. Third way, here's number three on your list. Size. Same thing, objects that are smaller will appear further away, depending on where they're at. Anything close to the front and size starts changing going backwards. Number four, details. Same idea. You know this is a stop sign because you recognize the shape of it, but you lose focus. The detail in the front, stop sign, is clear as day, right? So if I had a young man up here with curly hair, and I draw him, then I'm drawing all his curlies really super detailed. But the kid in the back over there, who also has curly hair, is just gonna look like a poof, or just a silhouette of a shape that looks curly. But over here, I have details because he's the one in the front, right? Cup of noodles, all right. Like you just spilled a cup of noodles on his head. Details. That's number four. Number five. Color and value. Color value. Objects that are further away are cooler. Cooler as in, this will be relative to color. We'll talk about color next time. But objects that are in front, these are the darker images. Anything that goes further back, you start changing tones or values. And those are how you determine what is further and furthest. If you looked out the window and you looked far into the distance, the mountains start getting blurry because they start getting eaten up by the sky, and then you start can't even realize where the sky and the mountains even meet each other, right? On a hazy day. That's that same idea. The closer you are, if you're standing in front of a mountain, you can clearly tell that there's dirt, trees, that kind of stuff. As you get further away, you start losing those details, you start losing values. Perspective. You guys talked about this one for 2 weeks last week. And before that, that's just going backwards on a paper and being in line. Those are the six ways. So here we go. Here's number one. I'll go back. You get the list?
Yes.
There's the list. Write down the list next to it. Yeah. Write down that list. These will come in handy later. Thank you for jotting down. You got your six? You got your six? Example one, positive or negative space? Which one's which? You can see it that way. Kind of a trick question because it can both be either one. Just depends who or what. How do you interpret it? One, the positive space could be the white bear hugging the black bear, right? Two, it could be the other way around. The black bear is hugging the white bear.
That's a black bear.
It's a bear.
Yeah,
black bear is
bear.
That's barely
a loser.
Well, you're missing the point.
Oh,
regardless,
each other.
The negative space could be all the black, right? The only thing that was actually drawn was the white, or the other way around. This is a white piece of paper and everything was painted in black. So which one's the positive and which one's the negative? Right? Here. What do you see? Which one of the types of six ways is being used in this one?
Color value.
Color value is one.
Overlapping.
Overlapping. Overlapping's two.
Expert.
Detail's three.
Overlapping.
Said that one already.
Placement's
good. Size, yes. And?
Perspective.
Perspective, probably. That was the last one that we probably could make an argument, but you're right. Size. Size of the mountain, the closest one to us, definitely there. Overlapping. The mountains are overlapped and you get further down. Color, right? The color is changing as it goes further back. Detail. Detail is in this mountain here. And then over here, it's just a silhouette, just like a little squiggly line, right? What else did we talk about? Size, yes, we talked about size. That was the first one. Anyone else? Placement on the paper. Mountain, going back that way. Perspective, there really isn't one because there's no vanishing point. There's a horizon line, maybe, but there's no real vanishing point. So there can be an argument made there. More specific, there's two of them. Which one?
Perspective.
Everyone wants to say perspective, but. Placement, detail, size, yes, those three. You can talk perspective a little bit, but placement, she's up front, right? House is way in the back. She's not the same size as the house, but she's obviously bigger. That's placement. Size, she is bigger than the house, but it's also lower to the bottom, so this is saying that it's closer than the house, because you know houses are not that big. They're actually bigger than that in real life, true. What about color? Yeah, it is darker up front in the front, and as she goes backwards, it does get changed and goes lighter, right?
She's scared of the
house. She's scared of the house, apparently.
Oh my god, there's two of them.
She fell. She fell and she can't get up and she's yelling. Alright, falling and I can't get up. Here you go. Come on down. How about now? What can you say about this one? How is space being used?
Color.
Okay, you find it. You say color. Anybody else? Perspective. Yes. And
memories.
Okay. What? Placement is good. Overlapping definitely here. Okay. Overlapping happening here. You can tell this one's further back. Size. Size, check out the size of the seaweed.
Oh, the rocks must have
right? Size, well, these three seaweeds are bigger than some of these buildings. But as you go further back, that's not the point. As you go further back, you can tell that those sizes are different. Details, up here in the front, you have bikini bottom, you have all these things going on right here in the details. As you go further back, see how the rocks start losing detail? Right? Positive, negative space, that big blue part is probably negative. Just out there, just sitting out there.
Where's the Christie crown?
So you see the little piece?
That's from the Christie crown.
Ooh.
Hey.
Dude, I really realized that in like 17 years I've been alive.
Where's the chum again?
Really?
Hey, I'm not worried about SpongeBob's house.
Far away from other things. They're not close to other things.
They're perspective. Okay. Back to what we're talking about. So, today, this is what I need you to do. But you saw how each picture has its own little version. There's six ways of talking about that. I need you to find your own. One, I need you to find your own image. Two, sketch it out on a piece of paper. Three, talk to your partner, agree before you start sketching it out that that's actually a good one to use. Four, answer this question. How? For example, the image that I found uses blank, type of six, to create the illusion of space. This is evident by, you tell me. Talk to each other, talk to your partner. You find a picture, open up Chromebooks.